Artist Toolkit
with Guitar Guitar.
Hey, I'm Sophie Burrell. I'm here up at Guitar Guitar Glasgow, and I'm going to tell you about my artist toolkit and my approach to songwriting. So songwriting can feel like a really intimidating thing, and I've always felt that way ever since I was like a kid, first trying to write my first riffs that I'd ever done. And I feel like it's super easy to overcomplicate it and overthink it, but when in actual fact, like, speaking from personal experience, my best ideas have come from when I'm not overthinking it and when I just kind of let it happen and don't force the creativity, if that makes sense. So my approach to songwriting back a few years ago, maybe when I released my first single, Tranquility, was completely different to my approach to songwriting now. I used to approach many things as a guitar player would, because guitar is and was my main instrument and always has been, so it's only natural. But these days I kind of approach songwriting more as a singer-songwriter, so more like sat down with an acoustic guitar, literally like, not campfire chords, but coming up with simple chords to accompany whatever melody I might have come up with, like vocally. But it doesn't always go that way. Sometimes I start with a riff and then that song would be more riff driven and guitar dominant, and you would be able to hear it, and you will be able to hear it when those songs are released as well. But I think it's really interesting and fun to kind of take the pressure off and really experiment with the different ways that you songwrite and which approaches work for you best and how the results are so different depending on which approach you take. Funnily enough, a lot of the time when I songwrite now, it usually starts with like a vocal idea, and it will normally be the chorus that I come up with, like a chorus melody. It may not even have words yet, and it will be a case of like humming along and trying to figure it out, and then finding out, you know, words with certain amounts of syllables, or like the way words are pronounced, like what sounds most pleasing to the ear with that melody. It doesn't always work that way though. Like sometimes I'll already have like a concept in my head about a song that I want to write, and then everything just kind of slots into place. It normally doesn't happen that easily. A lot of the time I have to fight for it. But again, like I said earlier, the songs that kind of write themselves are always the strongest ones for me at least, which is most infuriating as well. But there's also beauty in the process that comes with the songs that are a little bit hard and the ones you have to fight for, because they make it worth it in the end when you finally get the result that you're looking for. So my band Burrell's first single, Dare To, that chorus lyric, I can't remember exactly, but I feel like it came to me when I had either just finished parking my car, like really random time, or I was in the shower. A lot of inspiration comes in the shower for some reason, it just does. I feel like, I don't know, you're kind of like free to just do whatever you want and there's no judgment there. And you're also a cappella, so you can do what you want. But that's if you're taking like a singer-songwriter approach to something maybe. And what I would do after that is I would like find the melody, and then I'd sit down with a guitar and then kind of like back some chords behind it to give it a more complete idea. So in the case of Dare To, it was kind of like I came up with a you dare to call me her name, you don't want to be facing this. So it was the chorus idea, and then I sat down with my guitar. It's probably the wrong key now. Ah. You dare to call me her name, you don't want to be facing this. And I kind of just, I don't know, they slot together. It's a very simple riff. But it also joins up with the lyric on the "you don't wanna be facing this." So I also really like to play. Now, as you know, singing is a new instrument to me, and partnering it up with my guitar is really, really interesting, and finding how they kind of interact with each other is just something I very thoroughly enjoy exploring. And another really interesting case is sometimes I write songs in my dreams, which is like the most bizarre thing and also really cool. And there was a lyric that I came up with, or a melody, I don't really know. And it was just like, in my dream, I'm vegan, bear in mind, so this is even weirder. Fried chicken, fried chicken, fried chicken. And that was it. And I woke up and I was like, I know how to write this next song. And it was really weird. So obviously the song doesn't entail any words saying fried chicken in it, because that would just be weird. But I swapped it for sinking in, sinking in, sinking in to my skin. And that has become our next single. It's called Mess With Me. And depending on when this is released, it'll either be out or it will be out soon. And yeah, so I kind of sat down with my guitar again and was like,
sinking in to my skin, sinking in, breathe you in, I'll pull you in to my skin, wanna sin.
And then we kind of came up with it from there. So it's really funny, like, how all of these different things kind of interact with each other to finally kind of piece together the story in your head and to give you a song. So going back to what I was saying before about with my first single, Tranquility, having a completely different approach and approaching it as a guitar player before, I was really, I don't know, at that point I kind of also didn't really know who I was. I'm a lot more certain of that now. And I think songwriting as a singer-songwriter has really helped, because I'd never written lyrics before until kind of, you know, within the last year or two. So it's been really interesting, and like a lot of personal growth has happened as a result of that. I feel like songwriting is literally therapy to me, and it's the only way that I can properly express how I'm feeling. And I find it, like, did I say how I'm feeling or how I'm healing? Because it is healing as well, so it's kind of funny. But yeah, like back in the day, especially as a teenager, I was always really mad into like super technical guitar and guitar solos and fast and shreddy. And these days I'm like literally so reluctant, and I think that's okay. There are many shredders around, you know, in the industry, and it's cool if that's what you're interested in, what you want to do. But for me, I felt like I had more of a story to tell and more ways to express myself than to just play like 1,000 notes. And also, there's only so much I can listen to myself doing that before I get really sick of hearing myself doing that. And, you know, sometimes the most expressive things can come from the simplest ideas. Like, less is literally more, in my opinion. And I feel like leaving space, which is something I'm still learning, and it's no shame in that at all, but leaving space can actually have such a huge impact, and a lot of people don't realize it. I mean, to each their own, like, it's all based on personal opinion and what you like listening to and what you like writing, but that's just for me. Leaving space to actually let a story be told and to allow listeners to kind of establish their own emotions to what they're feeling and how they relate to that song is like so important, and I don't know, powerful. Songwriting is really powerful. So some of the gear that I use when I'm songwriting, and especially how this process has kind of gone with Burrell, has been really interesting. And I was chatting with someone earlier about this, but it isn't how, I don't know, I would have been used to taking a process before, like not heading to a studio and playing live together or having like a guitar specific day. All of us live really far away from each other, so we've had to become really innovative. Is that a word? Innovative? No?
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Innovative. I can't say the word anymore. With how we approach this process. And some absolute like golden pieces of gear that have allowed us to do this has been, for me, Two Notes Captor X. I know Sped uses a Two Notes, but I'm not sure which one it is. Two Notes Captor X, and I hook that up with my EVH 5150 lunchbox head. Little one can sit on my desk, I can tweak it, absolutely perfect. And then I'll run it through many different cab sims. One of my favorites has been the Victory Kraken. I think that with that amp, beautiful combination is good. And then yeah, dotting in pedals. Sometimes we add effects in post just to get a little bit more control over it as well. It really depends. But like, you can draw inspiration for so many things. Like, I wrote a part of a song that hasn't even been properly recorded yet, still a demo at this stage, for Burrell, with a synth pedal, literally just like mucking around with a few notes, and then it just completely shaped the song and allowed me to break through like a block that I had, you know. And I feel like it's important to just kind of use whatever you need to allow you to get what you're looking for from a song as well. So feel free to use literally the weirdest things. Doesn't even need to make sense a lot of the time. You know, songwriting is really free and flexible, and you can kind of do what you want with it. Like, sometimes we'll even use plugins to achieve certain tones, and some people might be a little bit shocked by that, especially people maybe of an older age group. Plugins are a bit of a weird one. I personally use them like all of the time, and just because they're digital, I don't think they sound any less good, so to speak. It's just different, and I think it just depends what the song is requiring as well. Those are just a few ways that I like to approach songwriting, and it really varies, but ultimately you should always just remember to kind of do whatever you want, because there are literally no rules when it comes to songwriting. So yeah, I've been Sophie Burrell, and that's my artist toolkit. I hope that you guys have enjoyed, and massive thank you to the wonderful peeps at Guitar Guitar for having me. Bye!